Good morning, Deify here, and welcome back to Final Fantasy X, where I'm gonna give the final boss another go. I've read up a little bit on strategeries for fighting Braska's final Aeon, aka Jecht. Just like that. And I feel like there might be a chance I can do it without needing to grind. Now, granted, I did grind a bit. I think I got everyone like 3 or 4 sphere levels, but people are at the edge of their sphere grids, and I need a lot of key spheres. Like, there's actually not too terribly much that I can really do to make them that much better. So I guess I'm just kind of gonna need to deal. Maybe I should look at what all these new weapons are when I get in there, instead of just walking straight up to Jack, because we know that that guy is gonna wait for us. He's got nothing but time. So that would probably be a good idea, because I bet some of these weapons might be useful. Like Prism Ball sounds pretty good. Mage's Staff. Actually, Prism Ball just sounds like it does elemental damage, so it might not be that good. Need to figure this out. That's not a friendly... Oh, that's a friendly thing. Okay, good. Don't want any of these stalagmites, okay? I just want these. Actually, if I can get through this without, like, ever hitting a stalagmite, I would be super happy. It might not... It might be kind of a pipe dream, but... You know. Come on, give me that one at least. Oof! Ah! This is getting way too close. Okay, come here, puppy. There we go. Infinity? Don't know what that is, but that is a big number. Hunting? Forgot about that one. See, I'm definitely getting the same stuff each time. There you are. No! Oh, don't do that. If I had hit that one, though, I would have been a little mad. Okay, it's gotta be here somewhere, right? There you are. No! There, I see it. Gimme. Flawless! How's it feel? You can't beat me, game. I'm way too good, okay? Okay, I hope we are at an understanding. So I wonder if you get a weapon for each person, because I know I got a white magic sphere, a skill sphere, and some other kind of sphere, a return sphere or something. So I wonder if maybe everyone got one weapon. But that means, who would Hunting go to? Is that Tidus's weapon then? Because Kamari got the Night Lance. That's without a doubt. Well, let's just see what we got going on. So, like, double penalty is really good. And that's actually a triple penalty right there. Sleep, silence, and dark? Like, I'm not super disappointed with that. Yeah, magic counter is not all that good. Poison touch, however. Poison touch. And strength plus 5, that's honestly probably a lot better if I had to guess. Mainly because I read that you can poison this guy. Stone Ward. We definitely found out that we want that, so let's do that. I gave Yuna this magic plus 10% rod because her other rod was magic plus 8 and sensor, and I don't think sensor is all that important. This curative ring is pretty gosh darn good. I don't think you're gonna beat that. Piercing and lots of strength. Let's see. So silence and stone's probably not that good. Piercing and zombie is something that would work, but I don't really think it's all that necessary. Like, I'm not super concerned about that. I would much prefer stone proof and poison proof. That sounds pretty good. Magic plus 5. Death Strike's pretty good, but it's really not that good. Let's be serious here. And really, her Moogle doesn't really matter. Stone Proof and Silence Proof, you can't beat that. Okay, so you got the Night Lance. Oh, that's pretty good. That is pretty good. That is a lot of strength that I just don't think I can turn down. Sleep Ward, Defense. Honestly, defense might not be so bad for him. I do like the Arc Sword for Tidus, but it may not be the best thing in the world. Yeah, you got Hunting. SOS Overdrive. No, because that doesn't really fit in with what I'm gonna be doing. my strategery that I'm bringing in. 1 MP cost and sensors. Pretty good. Not gonna argue with that. Nothing really good there. MP strolls like, eh. Whatever. I think that'll be pretty good, but... You know, honestly, I think it's also just partially gonna be a crapshoot. We'll see how it goes. What's up, Ject my man? Okay, I'm gonna have my sip of my lucky beer here. My first ever homebrew. Still working on that. It's been like 2 or 3 months. Still going strong, man. Digging it. Whenever you guys want to start talking is A-okay with
You're
me.
Late.
A wizard arrives precisely when he means to, or
I know.
Exactly when he means to, I don't know. See, because now that we've watched the cutscene, I can talk over it and not feel bad. What's up, Jectaruni? So I can just kind of give it my own little personal riffs, which is something that I really enjoy doing.
But you're all bones.
But I know there are important cutscenes where I'm like, let's not do that. But second time, it's like, eh, whatever.
Really grown.
Yeah, but you're still bigger.
Riku's just staring at Tidus in the background. She's just freaking me out.
That's
her head
funny.
Doesn't move anywhere. Jack, stop laughing. I said that wasn't funny, okay? Can you listen to me for once in your life, Dad?
Then. Let's end this.
Dad?
Yeah?
I hate you.
All this buildup and the weakest I hate you. I've ever heard.
You know what you have to do.
Yeah.
You yelled louder at the memory of him, like, when you woke up that night. Was that all the way back in Besaid? Wow.
Pretty soon I'm gonna be
time flies, huh?
Completely.
I really want to know how much time passed in the Final Fantasy universe. Like, a week? 2 weeks? How long does the pilgrimage take?
One thing, though.
It's like a 2-year thing? Like, they fell in love pretty quick, if it's only like a 2-week thing. It's like, hey... You ever think maybe you just fell in love, Yuna, because you knew you were kind of dead?
I'm sorry.
That's enough!
Is Riku still staring? No, she looked back at Jack.
Okay,
Jack, that's good.
You're right.
Nonchalantly turned the volume up a little bit more, because I don't need to hear myself talk. All I need to hear is this sweet song.
Well,
I mean,
then,
you know, once it starts.
Let's go.
Let's go. Ugh. Sorry, I wanted to join in the grunting too. I felt left out. That's what's hard when you're a game player. It's like sometimes you just want to feel emotionally invested with the characters and they don't allow you to because they grunt without telling you. Run, Tidus, you're going to need to be faster than that. Well, you tried. See, I think that just him falling is well deserving of one of the HD cutscenes that they had. I think that would have been sweet if he had like an actual facial expression so you could tell what he's feeling. Because I mean, like, did he want to catch Tidus too? That would have been pretty sweet to know. Like, this scene's beautiful, don't get me wrong. But it doesn't last long enough. Like, that's it. That's that HD cutscene right there. Now we're back to character models. Which is fine. They're not bad. I should learn to play this song on drums. Don't you give up on it. Wait, see. Okay, I got this down. Oh no, I got the line wrong. Wait, no, it's the second line. What's the first line then? Huh, I messed that up. Oh well, the important part is don't you give up on it. That's the part that we need to remember. Okay, so let's get Waka out here. He's got poison touch now, so maybe he can... Actually, I should have just gotten Lulu out. Lulu probably would have been a lot smarter, but... Yeah, who said anything about me being smart, you know what I'm saying? I don't plan to be very good at this game. Man, now it's really gonna bug me. What's the first line of the song that's not don't you give up on it? Bite the hand that feeds you. Come into the sand and the dust in time. No better plan than to do or to die. Oh, into the sand and the dust and the stuff. It's not time. Ah, I'm so bad at this song even though I like it. What am I doing? I'm thinking about the song more than I'm thinking about the actual fight. I'm over here like, huh, I don't remember this song as much as I used to, considering the fact I listened to it like several times throughout my college years. And by several times, I mean like it was on my metal playlist, and metal's really the majority of what I listen to, so I'm just saying. Bio him, please. We can poison him. I know this is possible. Fantastic. Okay. White magic. Sloga. Let's slow these guys down. We missed the pagoda on the right. That's a little unfortunate, but I'm not super concerned. Okay, Jek's got an overdrive. I got you. I understand. So supposedly you don't want to use Tidus's talking ability on this overdrive. If I had known he was going for Tidus, though, I would not have... actually, that only did 1700. Oh, right. I forgot about that again. Wow, that did not do a lot. That did not do a lot. Okay, 1460. I was hoping the poison would do, I don't know, a little bit more than 600 if I had to guess, but... Jeez, we're just gonna need to deal with this then. Granted, the pillars should be, like, off-kilter now. Like, that shouldn't be a problem. No, that you will. You know it. You will. He's not poisoned anymore. Which is a mild problem, if I had to guess. Okay. We'll be fine. Muna, I'm gonna swap you out. Let's go for Riku. See if we can get her some experience in all this with her 1 MP cost. How's it feel, girl? I know, right? Okay, let's see. What else do I want to do? I should probably be utilizing Auron far more than I am right now. Okay, so let's... Armor break? Why not? Get armor broken. Can we delay your attack? We most certainly can. Let's do that. Yeah, see, 3997 is a much better amount to be hitting. He's got an overdrive back, so I probably want to wait to summon an Aeon. That would probably not be the greatest idea to just, you know, go out guns blazing right now. But what I can do is a nice little... Let's just give him a seed cannon. Bam! How's that feel? 2180. Not too shabby, Kamari. And by that, I mean pretty gosh darn shabby. Like, are you even trying, Kamari? I would really prefer it if you would try and help this fight, okay? You know what? Yeah, see if... Just kill Tidus right there. See if I care. We got this. The unfortunate time when the pillars line up together. I kind of wish they wouldn't. But what are you going to do? We're still doing damage to him, so that's pretty gosh darn good. Man, maybe I shouldn't have used Auron to revive Tidus. Maybe I should have just waited and... So the problem is, like, I don't think Kamari or Auron would have died, but it might have been... Oh, Jesus. Actually not that bad. Do I want a magic break or power break? I don't know what attacks are which. Let's just try a power break. Titus, would you like to spiral cut him? Wow, what am I doing? I was like mashing the A button like, this is what I have to do. Spoiler alert, it's not what you have to do. Okay, Waka. Anything. I guess we'll just overdrive. It's not going to hit those. I don't care what we hit. We're going to go for water, which is after fire, which is after lightning. Thunder, same thing. Like, whatever. Stop badgering me. Okay. Oh! Actually, that did pretty nice. Okay. So the thing I learned about these Yu Pagodas is that when you kill them, they come back with as much HP as you overkilled them for. So since I killed them, they start with 5,000. Since I killed them with 9999, they'll come back with 9999. So there's really no way they can come back with more than that, as long as I kill them in one hit. Like, if I don't kill them in one hit, then it's like, oh, we got a problem. Okay, so the pagodas are coming back. Man, I'm just... Honestly, no, let's magic break him, because magic break might help us out as well. Ooh, not too shabby. Okay. See, even though he's close to an overdrive, it might be worth it to get, like, Bahamut out here. Bahamut. Just put the emphasis on every syllable. One of them's got to be the right pronunciation, right? Unless it's like, bam, bam, or something like that. I had to baw twice, because my first one I just ended. I just went like straight to the mutt and didn't even have the ha. So it's like, I tried my best, but my best just wasn't good enough. So the question is, do I think Bahamut can survive? Well, I mean, okay, he would have had two turns in a row anyway, so probably not. So I'm just gonna Mega Flare, because I believe the wiki said that his attack can cause like up to 4,000 or so damage. It's like, he might have been able to survive, but it might be best just to not find out that way, you know? Because otherwise he would have died with an overdrive, and that's just a gosh darn shame. We don't want to lose a perfectly good Aeon like that when we could do... Oh man, those pagodas are gonna have a lot of HP now. I thought Aeons didn't hit the... I thought we found out that... Oh, no, that was Seymour. Oh. They didn't hit the wheels behind Seymour, but they hit this. If you wanna, like, attack me once more, though? Like, I'm not gonna argue in the slightest. You know what? Power wave all you want, Buckarooski. Although, actually, he may be able to get his overdrive off, which would be a little annoying. We'll have to see how it goes. I want him to not get his overdrive off, because if we can get another overdrive off... No, he'll get Jacked Bomber. That's unfortunate. Ooh, hold on. Oh, how the tables have tabled. I had picked up my beer, because I was all ready to just die. Now I'm going to pick up my beer, but... This is going pretty gosh darn well, I would have to say. Bam! Perfect. Okay, how much is this gonna do? This should do quite a bit of damage still, right? I'd be disappointed if it only did like 10,000. Yeah, 23,000 more, no biggie. Oh, good. If you think the final boss is dead, though. Oh, you're in for a sorry surprise. Oh my gosh. Right now he like reminds me of Nightmare from Soul Calibur 2. His armor's not nearly as awesome, but good gosh. This guy is ready to mess me up. Slice, and that was it for Bahamut. He tried his very best, though, and we are very proud of him, okay? I hope you realize that, Bahamut. We desperately needed you. Okay. Yeah, Waka, why don't you go for it? 3200, and it's fine. But I think we're actually just gonna let Shiva try and deal with a little something-something. Because Shiva's got an overdrive as well. Granted, Shiva will not be able to survive nearly as well as Bahamut did. And are you serious? Are you serious? It's 3-1 now in the game I've got on in the background. When did that happen? It was 1-0 like 10 minutes ago. This is garbage. I hope that's not like showing me what's gonna become of this boss fight. Like, oh, it's gonna start off pretty well and then just fall into the garbage real quick, because that would be super unfortunate, and I hope that's not how it goes down. Okay, diamond dust, right? Snap your fingers, make him go boom. Yeah, see, it's only 10,000, which is a little disappointing. Because it's like, I mean, there's nothing I can do, though. Ooh, that's pretty good right there. That was pretty good, but you couldn't one him, ejecty boy. She had dodged that. That would have been real good. Just like, dodge. I got another overdrive. You ready, son? I'd be like, I am not ready. I will never be ready. Okay, back out we come, guys. So this worries me because I feel like... that sword attack will hit everyone. So I'm gonna power break him and just hope he does far less damage. Okay, yeah, keep doing that. That's fine. You know what? I'm even just gonna cure Orin again, because this guy's, he's important. He's important for the cause. Waka, you're important too, don't get me wrong. Oh, he's got armor back too. So that's an important thing to realize, that I'd probably armor break him a little bit more. Unfortunately, I can't do that right now. So in that case, I'm gonna use a burner Aeon. I'm gonna use a burner Aeon just to try and get some damage in him. So Yuna, you really gotta help me out here. Also, girl, I never noticed this, but watch your hair when you're summoning Ifrit, okay? Flames are real close to your face. That can't be good for your ends, okay? You've got beautiful hair. Let's not ruin it by this, with all this summoner nonsense, alright? Alright, did we score? No, we got hit in the face by something. That's not so good. 103,000! That's a lot. That's a lot. That is a lot. I wasn't expecting there to be so much HP. I was kind of hoping it would be like another 60,000 or something, but I guess now we're in it for the long haul, because who knows how long this could take? I certainly don't. Does he have an overdrive? Yeah, he definitely does. Oh, and he's gonna get to use it. Come on, I was gonna heal and I might have been able to survive. I can't remember how much, 3,100 or 3,000, it's somewhere, we might have survived. I was gonna heal on my next turn, just to hope. But it was just like, nah. That was it, it was just like, nah, I'm like, oh, okay. Kamari, is there something you can do? I really don't think, oh, wait, I know what we gotta do. Duh, who am I kidding? Do we want to haste or slow? I'm gonna slow first. I had to sing while thinking a little bit. That would happen, of course. You know, what do you expect, I guess? This game hates me. So maybe I should have hasted. You can't miss your hastes, I think. Check the beam, we should be fine. Okay, we are fine. I guess just attack him, and we will need an armor break. We will absolutely need an armor break. We'll probably need several armor breaks, all things told. But this should really help. This should make it so we're at least doing a fair amount of damage each turn. Oh boy, 3,000 damage to Tidus, oh boy. That's quite a bit of damage right there. Okay, what do I do? He's got an overdrive and Titus is dead. Do we get to go? We do. I'm gonna armor break him again. And then I may do the dumbest thing in the world, but I don't think it's that dumb. Ixion! Titus is gonna wake up and run off. There he goes, there he goes. Ixion, darling, we need you. I really wish I could have named this thing wrong. Why do I always blank on the band name? Who does? Come on. I have it, like, every time I'm not referencing it. Okay, just straight up, he's already got, like, 3 turns in a row. Thor's hammering. Wow, I googled this. It's gonna come to me right as I type it, isn't it? Thunder, of course. Death Clock, thank you, okay. That should just be our theme song, and I should have just named Ixion Death Clock. It would have been really good. But then I would have needed to name all my other Aeons. Naming Aeons isn't nearly as fun as naming Pokemon. I can name Pokemon for days. Aeons are just kind of eh. Is he zombified? No, no, he's berserked. I guarantee that's berserked. Okay, we survived the Jack Bomber, but it's not gonna help us at all. I guarantee you of that. We're gonna get taken down by the next one. Because he will have another attack right now. Yep. Bye, Ixion. You did real well. I'm very proud of you, okay? Man, we're already 30 minutes in. What if I mess this up? Oh man, now I'm like gonna start sweating and getting nervous. And Titus comes out and just dies again. Titus, if you're gonna get up to run off the stage, just stay alive. Is that too much to ask? Definitely better to use a Phoenix down, because that'll get Yuna another turn. Granted, I don't know what I'm going to do with that other turn. It's really not all that useful. Probably just going to trade her out. Okay. 3,300 is pretty good. It's pretty good. Oof. It's real close. That is real close, and I'm not a fan. So, but we want Auron. Probably to armor break again if I had to get. Oh, but. Oh, Titus, you better get a turn, okay? And then we want to trade Waka out for Yuna. Because we'll need a good heal. But we can't let him get this overdrive. Okay. So, it's unfortunate, but it just didn't work out so well. I do need to talk him out. You can only do that twice, so that's very important to remember. Let's armor break him again. Just keep it up, okay? We need all the breaks we can get. And I didn't realize that the Aeon overdrives affected the pagodas. There's really nothing I can do about them at this point. Like, they are gonna take a lot of damage to kill. Like, a lot. Let's get a Kiraga going. He's up. He's good. Auron's got this. And Titus, I would really like if you could get a Hastiga off. Hastiga, Slowga, something. But now that you're alive, hopefully you won't die. Okay, Hastiga definite. Oh gosh, Yuna and Auron were already hasted? I forgot that the haste didn't reset. That awkward moment of what do I do here? Go for a power break, honestly. Ugh, I hope that's not the dumbest idea in the world. We'll soon find out that at worst he can only kill Titus. He can't kill Titus and Auron. Oh crap, actually he might get his overdrive. Oh crap, he might be able to kill Titus and Auron. Don't. Oh, thank you, game, you're way too kind. Auron? Yes. Okay, Phoenix down on Yuna. And go for the Slowga again, please. Hit. Okay, we hit one, that's something. This is bad. This is really bad. This is not where I want him to have an overdrive. He didn't use it, thankfully, so that's pretty nice. And Orin might be able to survive, actually. Or is this his overdrive? It doesn't seem like it should be. Orin won't be able to survive it. Because apparently that will just always kill you no matter what. Whatever. There's no way that's his overdrive. I refuse to believe it. That was his overdrive. Really? That's not concerning at all. I thought it would be like a sweep with the sword that would hit us all. See, like, that would have been real bad. If you use an item, you go in there. Honestly, it's probably for the best anyways. Because life doesn't do anything that... See, now it's worth a piece, basically. Life doesn't do anything that a Phoenix Down wouldn't do, and a Phoenix Down lets you go again, like, a lot sooner. So I'm like, yeah, let's do it. Okay, don't die. You died. That's a problem. Let's try magic breaking, because that did a lot of damage last time. I don't know why it did so much damage. It didn't look like we got a critical, but when we did a magic break on the last form, it did 9999, like, hello. How do I get more of that in my life? Okay, we definitely still want Yuna alive, though. Let's go for it. Let's cheer. Let's cheer on Orin, at least. Like, that's the real point here, is I want Orin's strength up. Oh, see, this is what I was worried about. Oh, this is what I was worried about. That's dumb and bad and dumb bad. And he gets his overdrive. Awesome. So what do I do here? Well, that's a good question, viewers. We'll find out, I guess. I think Triumphant Grasp might be his overdrive, in which case I'm not worried. Take Yuna. No, you had to take Orin. Okay, it could be worse. I really wanted to take Yuna because Yuna's not hasted, not cheered. You really gonna do this to me, game? It's not gonna give me anything to work with? Okay, Orin, buddy, we need you awake, okay? I could really use your expertise right now. If I can get to Yuna's turn, though, I might be able to call out Valifor and do some extra damage. Gosh, this is... This battle is a lot harder than I thought. I don't have Sensor anymore. Okay, well, Valifor, we're probably gonna need you. You're probably not gonna do too much. But he is armor broken, he's power broken, he's magic broken. I don't know what else you want from me. He's just broken, so let's ruin him more. Okay. I'm sorry, beg pardon, how much damage have I done? Only 13,000? Only 13,000. I'm a little miffed right now, I'm gonna be totally honest. I'm like, now it's down even lower. Okay, so Valifor was an absolute waste. Only 13,000, like now it's probably down to like 12,000 or something. Wow, are you kidding me? Okay guys, let's get hasted here, because apparently we gotta do a lot more damage than I thought. Get a Cura on Tidus. Hopefully he won't be swept out in like one hit. Zombie attack. I know zombie affects him. This might be the edge we need. Oh, but they cure zombie, don't they? Let's see, is he still zombied? Yeah, he's still zombied. Oh man, that's rip. Oh man! Just not doing enough damage! That was going so well for the first part. I think zombie might be our way in, though, depending on Yuna's MP, because, like, Kira does, like, 6,000? Well, we got to the second form, so I'm pretty happy about that. Think we can do it. I might actually need to grind a little bit more than I thought, though. I'm supposed to remind you to like, comment, and subscribe if you enjoyed the video. Until next time on Final Fantasy X, where if we make any progress like we have over the last couple videos, we will beat Braska's final Aeon. Goodbye.